In this tutorial, we're going to review the page formatting and see if there's anything that we missed or need to add on to. So let's go up into the format page. And we see in the organizer tab, we covered this next style pretty thoroughly in the left and right margins. Page, we covered this information when we made the envelope. The background is pretty well explained in the watermark tutorial. We didn't do the colors, but it's pretty obvious how to put those in. The header and footer tabs here. We talked about headers and footers. Let's just take a quick review of this. Turning this on, same content on left and right. That should make sense now that we've looked at the left and right pages. We've got our left margin. That's changing it up on the tab. Pretty obvious, but we can show you right here. By adding some here, we see our left margin gets moved in. Same with the right margin, spacing. The height set to auto fit, so it will get bigger if you add more lines, get smaller if you take away the lines. More. This is the borders and the background. Background, like just like we did in the watermark, but you can do it only for the headers. Kind of cool. And you can also place borders around the header. And this was all covered in the paragraph, so we're not going to go over it again. Now we've got our footer tab, same as the header. Borders, just like we saw with the header, it's covered pretty well in the paragraph topic. So if you really want a little more information on it, I'd suggest you review the paragraph tutorials. Columns was covered in the columns tutorial. Footnote, here's something that we have not really talked about in the page style. We talked about footnotes and did a whole tutorial on that, but I think I missed this part of it. This tab gives you a little more control of how much of the page you want to allow for the footnote. And the little line right above the footnote, you can change the position of it, the style, the color. I don't think I mentioned that in the footnote tutorial, so I'm mentioning it right now. A few other things I wanted to talk about in this topic are under tools. They are the word count. Tells you how many words are in your document, how many characters, and characters excluding spaces. This might come in handy if you needed to maximize the use of spaces on a job application on the internet. Maybe you're given only 250 or 300 characters. Type it up in LibreOffice, get it the way you like it, then just do a cut and paste. The other tool I wanted to talk about is the line numbering. We can turn on line numbering, and it gives you the character style and format and positioning. We're going to leave those all defaults. The interval every 5 lines. Let's see how this looks. So you've got 5, 10, 15, 20. You notice that one line for my graphic here. When you've got more text, it makes a little more sense. Let's try turning these on every line. Changing the interval to one line. Now we can see every line in the document. We can also tell it to restart every new page. So we have 1 at the top of this page, comes down to 37, then we go to 1 on the top of the second page. We can also change this interval to 10, and here we've got a separator. Let's change this to a dash and put this every 5 lines. Clicking OK, we see 10, then our dash, 5 lines in, making this 15. Then we've got our 20, a number, and our dash for our 25.